So now we look at the clinical aspects of brachial plexus. First one is the total injury. The damage to the brachial plexus as a whole will cause paralysis of serratus anterior muscles, rhomboideus muscles. It also, we are told that brachial plexus, the T1 ventral rami has supplied the sympathetic chain. So the total injury to brachial plexus cause sympathetic problems, which are summarized by a syndrome known as Horner's syndrome. Horner's syndrome is due to damage to the ventral rami of T1 spinal segment in the brachial plexus. The features are, first one is partial ptosis or the paralysis of the Muller's muscle, leading to the drooping of eye. Second one is meiosis or constriction of pupil due to paralysis of dilator pupillae. Next, we will have anhidrosis or absence of sweating due to damage to the pseudomotor supply. We will have flushing in the faces due to vasomotor problems. And finally, there is loss of ciliospinal reflex. Ciliospinal reflex is actually the constriction of pupil by the pinching of the nape of the skin of neck. These five features are actually seen in Horner syndrome, which is caused by damage of the T1 ventral rami or spinal of the brachial plexus. Now we will look up what happens if there is injury to the upper trunk of brachial plexus. Guys, do you remember the S point that I told before? Check. C5 and C6, the rootlets unite to form the upper trunk, which divides to form an anterior and a posterior division. There are two nerves coming out from here. One is nerve to the suprascapular nerve and a nerve to subclavius. Suprascapular nerve and nerve to subclavius. There is an anterior division and a posterior division. So this point is actually the S point. In forceps delivery, when the baby is taken out using a forceps, there occurs damage to the upper trunk of brachial plexus, and we have a clinical feature which is known as Porter's hip or waiter's hip or policeman hip. The typical features in Porter's hip are adduction and medial rotation of arm, adduction and medial rotation of arm, followed by extension and pronation of forearm. The muscles that are causing adduction is the paralysis of deltoid and supraspinatus, and by the overactivity of adductors of the upper limb. The muscles causing the problems in medial rotation is actually the paralysis of infraspinatus and teres minor, and the overactivity of medial rotators. Muscles causing extension is actually the paralysis of biceps brachii, brachialis and brachioradialis. Biceps brachii, brachialis and brachioradialis, and the overactivity of extensors of the upper limb. And the pronation is actually due to paralysis of supinator and biceps brachii, and overactivity of the pronators of upper limb. Suppose what will happen if there is injury to the lower trunk of brachial plexus by a fall from a height or to the presence of a cervical lip? Then we will come across a condition known as clump his paralysis, where the lower trunk formed from C8 T1 dividing the two branches get paralyzed. Here, it may be due to fall from a height or due to presence of a cervical lip or the hyperabduction of the brachial plexus of the arm, upper limb. The typical clinical feature in Clunky's paralysis is a complete claw hand. Complete claw hand. So, complete claw hand is represented by the extension of the wrist with the hyperextension at the metacarpophalangeal joints and flexion at interphalangeal joints. So this is the typical representation of a complete claw hand, where there is wrist will have hyperextension, then the fingers will have at metacarpophalangeal joints it will be hyper extended, and at interphalangeal joints it will be hyperflexed. So this is the clinical feature in Clunky's paralysis, as there is damage to the lower trunk and damage to the T1. Of course, there will be damage to the sympathetic plexus supplied by the T1, and which can also cause Horner's syndrome. That we explained. And the final clinical application related to brachial plexus, for our knowledge, is giving brachial plexus nerve block for the surgery to the upper limb. The anesthetic solution can be introduced to the brachial plexus, to the supraclavicular triangle, in the posterior triangle, and it will cause anesthesia to the muscles and loss of sensations. So, the four clinical features are, first one is Horner syndrome in total injury, the second are ears, palsy or policeman or waiter's tip, third is Clunky's. See, and the fourth one will be nerve block. So that sums up the brachial plexus, and you must know how to draw the brachial plexus. You will rise from C5, C6, C7, C8 and T1. The nerve roots coming will have three roots. The five roots united to form three trunks are T, D, C, root, trunk, division and cord. The trunk will have three posterior divisions to form the posterior cord, then the anterior divisions will unite to form the median, the lateral root, then we will have this medial cord formation. So this is a musculocutaneous nerve, this is a median nerve, and this is the ulnar nerve. This will be the posterior cord with axillary nerve and radial nerve and related to the apex point. And this is all about brachial plexus.